Will this parse? No. No, it didn't. Now I have 14 quick challenges for you to see how well do you know JSON. Because clearly you didn't even get the first one right, but hey, guess what? I don't think you're gonna get more than 10 right on this. So let's find out, will it parse? Will it stringify? Do you even know JSON? All right, so let's start off easy. What happens when you pass in a string number? Good job, it parses it as a number. Now we're all familiar with IEEE 754-1985, which of course allows for negative zero in the floating point specification. So how does JSON parse handle it? Parses it as a zero, which I guess I'm not too upset about. Okay, so let's step up the difficulty a little bit. What about the scientific notation 10E5? 1 million, of course. It's to be expected. Which of course makes this answer obvious. What happens when you parse a hexadecimal? Results in an error, of course, at token X. You didn't see that one coming? Come on.
Everyone knows about hexadecimal failure while JSON parsing.
Right? What happens if you stringify NaN? Null. So this obviously makes infinity null.
It's beautiful.
All right, so let's put our thinking cap on. What happens when you parse 9 quadrillion, 700 trillion, 199 billion, 254 million, 740,995? Well, duh, it comes out with 996. All right, we have 7 left to go. I know you're not doing as well as you were really hoping, but don't worry, it's not going to get any easier. What happens when we stringify a new foo? An empty object. And I'm somehow not upset about that. But what happens if we stringify undefined? Well, undefined comes right back out. Obviously, if we can stringify it, we should be able to parse it. What is the result of a stringified undefined pass to parse? An exception, of course, at position 0. I know, it kind of hurts a little bit, doesn't it? I don't really like that. After that moral beating, I decided to toss you a softball. What is the result of stringifying this object? An empty object. Good job. And of course, stringifying an array with a single undefined in it. An array with a single null inside of it. Somehow I hate this. I hate this game we're playing. All right, this last one's gonna have to combine everything you know about JavaScript. What is gonna happen when we parse this string? Well, of course it produces a string. Didn't you look at it? It's just a string that contains a string. You didn't even see that, did you? You didn't. Don't lie to me. You liked this video, so press the like button. It was entertaining, I know it was. Hey, subscribing means a lot to me, and hey, YouTube thinks you're gonna like this video, so just follow it. Just watch it. They picked it out for you.